thing, you raise me up while we're waiting.
Yeah, we can.
Let's do that.
Yes, sorry. Let's do that.
Okay. Sorry about that extra exercise, Delisa. What we'll do at this time, Athalie will... You ready? Oh, okay. All right. Your mom would appreciate all this up and down.
Good morning, everyone. Sandra Singh Birbal, born on November 13, 1945, was one of the most dynamic and unforgettable individuals that anyone who was fortunate enough to be graced with her acquaintance would have ever met. She made an indelible impression on most and had the unique ability to relate to persons from all walks of life, from the CEO of a company to the janitor, and make each person feel special. One of my mom's favorite songs, which she often sang to us, was Que Sera Sera. She lived her life by that motto, and of whatever would be, and whatever life threw at her, she made the best of the circumstances. Indeed, life threw many obstacles at her, and she surmounted them all and excelled. One such instance was when her parents died when she was still quite young. In spite of that, she started putting herself through nursing school, at which time she met the love of her life, the handsome and charismatic Bastir Birbal. They married and lived an idyllic life until tragedy struck once again and he died, leaving her with four small children, all under the age of 11. Indeed, it would have been very difficult for her, yet she always maintained a very witty, jovial, and fun-loving spirit. As a single parent, she was a supermom. She instilled great values in her children and always encouraged us all to aim for excellence. She was strong, independent, and confident, and stood apart from every other parent that we knew in that era. Mom was also a remarkable beauty, and growing up, our friends always commented on how stunning she was. She prided herself not only on her physical appearance, but also in every aspect of her life, from her home to her garden. She strove to always improve herself and did numerous courses in interior decorating, sewing, horticulture, foreign languages, she practiced yoga. She was just always on the go. As she got older and more nostalgic, she would relate stories of her childhood, like when Michelle was young, she took $100 from Mom's dresser to try to give to a fish vendor after Mom told him that she had no money. Or that I only liked my immediate family and would cry and randomly bite anyone who tried to pick me up as a toddler, which led to my name Red Ants. Nigel would go under her dress as a kid and repeatedly say, "I see Mommy Bambi, Mommy, Mommy Bambi." Vanessa would say as a child, when she and Nigel would play shop together, "Mommy, Nana called me Parlor Lady." As she would also often recount her humble beginnings and all of her fun escapades and mischievous pranks with her brother, Channon. Her grandkids were definitely the apples of her eye. And all that we could never get away with, they did in abundance. She would make excuses for them not to get punished and was very protective of them. Your final obstacle, Mom, of your health issues, you fought courageously till the end. We all always spoke of your will to live after being hospitalized on numerous occasions. You finally left us before anyone arrived, and I truly believe that you did not want us to witness you in that condition. As you would often say, if we were in pain, that you wish we could give the pain to you to bear. We know in our hearts that you are in a better place with our dad looking over us, our angel forever, Que Sera Sera.
Thank you so much, Delisa. Now we'll be led in that song that Sandra sang so often, Que Sera Sera.
My only concern is that I'm not a little girl, but let's make the best of it, amen? So if you know sing, if you don't, sing the chorus with me. When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother, what will I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be rich? Here's what she said to me. Que sera, sera, whatever, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera, what will be, what will be. When I grew up, I fell in love. I asked my sweetheart, what lies ahead? Will we have rainbows day after day? Here's what my sweetheart said. Que sera, sera, whatever will be, our future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera, what will be? What will be. Now I have children of my own. They ask their mother, what will I be? Will I be handsome? Will I be rich? I tell them tenderly, que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see, que sera, sera, que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see, que sera, sera. What will be, que sera, que sera, sera.
Thank you for that. And now Corey will bring a tribute for us.
Sandra Singh Birbal was many things: a wife, a mother, a daughter, a sister, an aunt, a cousin, a gardener, a chef, a landlord, and a grandmother. When I was born in Canada, 32 years ago this month, she traveled thousands of miles to Toronto, leaving behind her beloved Trinidad for a little while to be with her daughter, Michelle, and help her baby grandson. And then she did it again 10 years later when Tristan was born. That's who she was, though. Someone as something as minor as distance would not prevent her from being there for her family. I called her Mama because, like a lot of babies with a working mother and a lacking father, I spent a lot of time with my grandmother and assumed she was my mom. That may sound like a tragedy, but it really isn't. After all, who needs a dad when you have two moms? I first came to Trinidad when I was three. I remember the Trinidad sunshine hitting my face for the first time. The same sunshine that always called her home, no matter how far she strayed. When I got here, the family had got me a little toy golf set. I remember playing with it with Mama and Vanessa in the garden, the most beautiful garden on the whole hill. Auntie Vanessa was always the best at playing with me. I remember watching TV with Mama and Nigel, watching local Trini news, back when it was less about crime and more about cricket and carnival. Nigel would always change the channel to MTV the minute she walked away. Uncle Nigel was always the best at showing me things I shouldn't be watching. One day after a gap from seeing her for a while, I walk out of school at the end of the day, and lo and behold, Mama and Delissa are waiting for me. I was so proud that my beautiful, young, glamorous grandma was picking me up from school in her fancy new car. She was, after all, the epitome of style and grace. We hung out and got food, and we got ice cream, and Delissa bought me a toy. Auntie Delissa was always the best at buying me toys. It was actually one of the best days of my life. And then when I was 11, she got cancer, and she moved in with us, and we shared a room. She was my first roommate, but she was also my best friend. I had skipped school a couple times to go sit with her while she did her chemo. Even in that time, the darkest of hours, she was playful and vivacious and fun. But that was her. No matter her age or what challenges she faced or what illnesses riddled her body, she was eternally and unyieldingly youthful. For her, youth was not a time of life, but a state of mind. I know we're all gathered here today to say goodbye and see her one last time, and I know it's cliche to say, but I'll still see her after today. I'll see her in the tenacity of my mom. I'll see her in the grace of Delissa. I'll see her in the intelligence of Vanessa, and I'll see her in the heart of Nigel. In the composite of her 4 kids and 2 grandkids, she will always be here. Her blood runs through us all. I also have a letter she had written to Tristan about 20 years ago. I'm going to read it on his behalf. Hi, Tristan. How are you, sweetheart? Mama is writing this letter for you. Corey or Michelle will read it for you. Did you like your birthday cards? Christmas is coming soon. Tell your mommy to come to Trinidad. All of you should come to Trinidad for Christmas. I heard you like to bathe in your truck. That's nice. You must bathe in the court only with your cocoa outside. You must not go in the road with your cocoa. Okay? Mama miss you very much, and Corey too. When you come by Mama house, you will play in the lawn. You will like it here. You are a cute, cute baby. Mama loves you very much. Auntie Van told me to write you this letter because I sent a letter for Corey and I forgot to send one for you. I am sorry, darling. Just now you will be a big boy and you will read all your letters, okay? Mama is going to make bacon shark now. You see, if you were here, you and Corey would eat plenty. You know Mama wants to get a parrot, but first I have to make a cage for him to stay. I will get a small baby parrot and I will teach him to talk. When he is able to talk, I want him to say, hi Tristan, hi Corey. He will be Mama's best friend. No, I remember you said you are my best friend, okay? Love you, sweetheart, be good. Kiss your brother and your mommy and daddy and say I love you. Bye now and be a good boy. We'll write you again, kiss, kiss, my mom. Thank you.
Thank you, Corey, for that very touching, very eloquent eulogy. And I'm glad the order flowed like this because now Tristan is able to read. So we listen as Tristan reads to us Psalm 23.
So this is Psalm 23, the King James Version. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I would also like to read this prayer book that Mama had before she was married. She marked a couple passages in here that I would like to read. So the first one I would like to read is Remembrance for Each Day. The will of God be done by us, the law of God be kept by us, our evil will controlled by us, repentance timely made by us, Christ's passion understood by us, all sinful deeds be shunned by us, our last end pondered oft by us, and death be blessed found by us, with angels' music heard by us, and God's high praises sung by us, forever and for aye, amen. And I would like to read a prayer for guard of the tongue. O Jesus, Son of God, who was silent in the presence of Pilate, do not allow us to lose our tongues without thinking on what we have to say and how we may say it. That's it.
Thank you, Tristan. Now Carrie will read to us from 2 Corinthians chapter 5.
Morning, everyone. The second reading is a reading from 2 Corinthians chapter 5 to 10. For we know that when the tent we live in our body here on earth is torn down, God will have a house in heaven for us to live in, a home he himself has made, which will last forever. As we now sigh, too great is our desire that our home, which comes from heaven, should be put on over us. By being clothed with it, we shall not be without a body. While we live in this earthly tent, we groan with a feeling of oppression. It is not that we want to get rid of our earthly body, but we want to have the heavenly one put on over us. So that what is mortal will be transformed by life. God is the one who has prepared us for this change, and he will give us his spirit as the guarantee of all that he has in store for us. So we are all full of courage. We know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord's home. For our life is a matter of faith, not sight. We are full of courage and would much prefer to leave our home in the body and be at home with the Lord. More than anything else, however, we want to please him, whether in our home here or there. For all of us must appear before Christ to be judged by him. We will each receive what we deserve according to everything we have done, good or bad, in our bodily life.
Thanks be to God for his word. Thank you, Carrie. And now, Athalie will lead us in singing a verse and chorus of You Raise Me Up.
So we get to the first verse. When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Let's bow in prayer for a moment. Loving Lord, we give you thanks for life and for life beyond this life. And as we think of your dearly beloved, our dearly beloved Sandra Birbal, we pray that you would give us strength. We pray that your sustaining grace would flow into our lives. We pray for the comfort of your Holy Spirit with us. And we pray that the memories we have would light our way, because they show us love and laughter. Hear our prayers which we offer in the name of the only one who could tell us, I was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. And in his name, the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. As we think of Psalm 23, we hear the familiar words, the Lord is my shepherd, believed to have been written by King David about 3,000 years ago. And David himself was a shepherd. He knew what it was like to look after sheep. They were difficult, they were troublesome, they were often disobedient. They were perhaps almost as difficult as children. And David writes, the Lord is my shepherd. And David writes about what a shepherd does to protect, to prepare. Later on in the Bible, we are told that all of us are called to be shepherds, with Jesus being like the chief shepherd. And God sends people into our lives to be shepherds to us. Grandparents, parents, and today as you think of Sandra Birbal, you may think of someone who has been a shepherd to you. You heard about her in that letter she wrote to Tristan when he was so young, talking to him about the bacon shark. Bacon shark can be a banqueting table. A banqueting table in the presence of enemies. The enemies don't have to be people, you know. The enemies can be our own fear and frustration and loneliness, our sense of being isolated from everybody, our own anger, our own sense of loss and pain. And the banqueting table, that could be somebody telling you, take a deep breath, sit down, eat something, you'll feel better. As you hear that, you may remember Sandra's voice telling you to eat something. You remember the food that she prepared. In her life, she lived the life of a shepherd, whether working as a nurse or in the admin at Hugh Wooding or Huey, caring for the children, loving the friends and family in her life. Later on, she wasn't well, and other people had to be shepherds to her, to look after her. We give God thanks for them as well, because that's how shepherding graces work. We lead each other in the correct paths. We lead to the green pastures and the still waters, to make sure that souls and hearts and minds are calm and are surrounded by beauty and peace, by the loveliness that sometimes in this world reminds us that God prepares for us. People who love us, a beautiful life and a beautiful world, And we give God thanks for all the goodness that we see. When we hear the words from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, which Carrie read to us, we are reminded that our earthly bodies are fragile. The image of a tent is used. Tents are always temporary. And we are told no matter how well we look after our body, there will come a day when the earthly tent has to be taken down and folded up and packed away, and it will disintegrate. No matter how much we look after it, there will come a day when that will happen. And today we give God thanks for Sandra, beautiful in every way. And yet 2 Corinthians chapter 5 tells us, well, now that we know that, how do we live? We are told we walk by faith, not by sight. We live by that faith, knowing that wherever we go and wherever we live, goodness and mercy follow us. As Psalm 23 says, some of you would have seen hurricanes and images of tornadoes on the news. And you would see that after the hurricane or the tornado passes, there's a trail of destruction. Well, Psalm 23 talks about the opposite, a trail of blessing, goodness and mercy, the loving kindness of God. They follow me like a trail of blessing, like a pathway from paradise. All the moments of every day of my life, and wherever I live, wherever I go, wherever I visit. And we think of all those who are in this room who have come from far away, and those who will be looking through the streaming or listening to a recording through the marvels of modern technology. Wherever we are and wherever we go, Psalm 23 reminds us, we shall live in the house of the Lord. And the Bible even tells us our body is the temple of God, because the Spirit of God lives in us. And we shall live in the house of the Lord. And Psalm 23 says, I shall dwell in the house of the Lord, not only today, not only tomorrow, but forever, forever. And today, as we think of Sandra Birbal, and today as we give God thanks for all the beauty, all the blessing that we experienced in her life, for all the shepherding gifts and graces, for all the times she prepared that banqueting table, or led us to the green pastures and the still waters, or her laughter resounded in our lives and reminded us that the world is a beautiful place. Today we give God thanks for that forever promise, because we know she will never be sick again. She will never suffer again. She's in the house of the Lord forever. Thanks be to God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now we'll join together in singing All I Ask of You.
I don't think it's in the program, but we just do one verse. It's in the program? Okay. All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. All I ask. All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. Deep the joy of being together in one heart, and for me that's just the way it is. All I ask, all I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. As we make our way through all the joys and pain, can we sense our younger, truer selves?
All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. Someone will be calling you to be there for a while. Can you hear the cry from deep within? All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. Laughter, joy, and presence, the only gifts you are. Have you time? I'd like to be with you. All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. Persons come into the fiber of all life, and then their shadow fades and disappears. But all I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you.
Let's bow in prayer. Loving Lord, we give you thanks for this day. And as we think of Sandra, mother, grandmother, beloved companion along life's journey, we give you thanks for the memories we have of her. We think of the things that she said or wrote or did that truly blessed us, that truly showed us that she was sent to be a shepherd in our lives, to lead us to the green pastures and the still waters so that we could bless the lives of others and we could build on the foundations that she built for us. We give you thanks for that, O Lord. As we think of her dedication and devotion, as we think of her service and sacrifice, we pray that even now as we are grieving, that you would remind us that everybody grieves differently. Be with us when we feel we want to talk a lot. Be with us when we feel we cannot speak at all and we need to be quiet. Be with us and show us that you enlighten our lives and you bless us. Whatever we are going through, O Lord, comfort us with the consolation that can come only from heaven. Hear our prayers, for we offer this prayer and all the prayers of our hearts, all the prayers for our loved ones. We offer them in the name of Jesus and in the gracious words that Jesus tenderly taught us. We pray as we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. At this time, I'll invite you to please stand for a closing prayer, which will include the prayers of committal. And following this, the family members will be given flowers and they can come forward and place them as we are led in the singing of How Great Thou Art, and then into your hands. So, Lord, we come to you in prayer as we think of Sandra and as we think of ourselves. We know that in our earthly journey, it is earth to earth and ashes to ashes and dust to dust. But we trust in your mercy and your grace, O Lord, because only you can bring life out of death and light out of darkness. Be with us, O Lord, because you have brought life and immortality to light. You give us the assurance of life that is everlasting. And so, O Lord, we commend Sandra to you, even as we prepare to commit her to the elements, We do this in the blessed assurance of the immortality of the soul, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Grant eternal rest unto her, O Lord, and may light perpetual shine upon her. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through your divine mercy and your holy grace, rest in peace. And grant unto us, O Lord, that we would be accompanied by the prayers of the saints until that day when we are welcomed by the songs of the angels. And may we hear the voice of our Savior saying, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Enter now into the joy of the Father." Until then, may the blessing and the power and the peace and the presence of our one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, rest and remain and abide upon Sandra Birbal, upon all those she loves, and upon all those we love, wherever they may be in heaven or on earth, on this day and forevermore. Amen. So God bless you. I will leave at this time, and most of you can be seated. The family members will be given the flowers to place as we join together in singing "How Great Thou Art," and then "Into Your Hands" as we prepare for the casket to be taken in for cremation. So I will continue to keep you all in prayers as we remember her. God bless you.
When I, in awesome wonder, consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout God to be. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to be. His Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross my burdens gladly bearing, he bled and died sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Shout of acclamation to take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall. humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
your mercy